To make it easier to follow along with the lesson, please reset your user setting or make sure the mouse preset is on 3-button or regular mouse. If you do not know how to change the settings, please watch our UI video first. In this tutorial, we are going to cover the workflow of the animation mode in Marvelous Designer. I will also introduce the tag tool, paint tool, and wind controller. Before we start the simulation, we need to prepare the garment and optimize it. A low particle distance like 5 will give you a realistic result, but will slow down the simulation dramatically. For multi-layered garment, increase the particle distance to 8 for interlayers that are not as visible as the outer layers. Set the particle distance to 12 for parts that does not require higher level of expression of wrinkles. The collar area has a lot of self-collision and require higher level of expression of wrinkles during simulation. Since this piece of pattern is too large and it's not efficient to reduce the particle distance for the whole piece, we can use the select mesh brush and paint on the part near the collar. Right-click and select Sub-UI. Turn it on Mesh Display, and you can see that the part we painted on has double amount of subdivisions. Buttons in Marvelous Designer are geometries. They are heavier to simulate. Fastening the buttons using the Fasten Button tool gives you quick and realistic result for draping, but it is not as stable when simulating an animation. So I'm going to unfasten them and cheat it with sewing. Select the Fasten Button tool and drag a box around the buttons. We'll remove the fastening relationship. Click and hold the Internal Line tool and select Internal Ellipse. Hold Ctrl while dragging from the middle of the button will create an internal ellipse from the center. Create the internal shape with the radius near the radius of the button. Since the patterns are symmetrically linked, the internal ellipse are also created at the buttonhole. Click and hold the sewing tool and choose free sewing. Double-click on a point on the sewing line for both sides. The sewing relationship is created for the whole loop. However, we can see from the 3D window the sewing lines are crossing. To fix it, click and hold the sewing tool again and choose Edit Sewing. Right-click on the sewing line and click Reverse Sewing or use the hotkey Ctrl-B. Repeat the process for the other button. Freeze the rest of the garment and simulate. The reason why I freeze the other patterns first is to protect the look of them and also make the simulation faster. Hide the cape and unfreeze the vest. We need to repeat the process for the buttons on the vest as well. We do not need to repeat this process for the buttons on the shirt, because there is already internal lines and sewing relationship present. This shirt is brought in from the modular configurator. Next, I want to clip this tie onto the shirt. The reason why I went with a clip-on tie instead of a real tie is because the neck part is hidden under the collar. We want to delete and reduce any unnecessary layers for simulation. To constrain the tie onto the shirt, we will use the tag tool. Unhide the cape using the hotkey Shift Q. Then select the vest, the cape, and the collar of the shirt. Right-click and select the active pattern and sewing, then hide these patterns. Unfreeze the tie and place it near the neck. Use the tag tool and create a point on the tie and another point on the shirt where you want the constraint to be. You can edit the points using the Edit tag tool. Click Simulate and the tie will stick to the shirt at the spot where you created the tags. Use the Move Edit tool to adjust the shape of the tie. Press Ctrl H to strengthen will make it easier to untangle. Create another tag on the tip using the Tag tool, so the tie won't shift position during simulation. Unstrengthen the tie and bring back the top layer patterns one by one. I will also use Tag tool to constrain the cape to the shirt at the shoulder. Turning on opaque surface will make it easier to visualize the tag points. Tag on Avatar tool will constrain the garment to the skin of the avatar. I'll constrain the shirt to the avatar at the neck area to mimic tying around the neck. Since we can't see the inside of the pocket, I will delete it to make the simulation lighter. Select the internal line, right-click, and choose Cut. Delete the inside part. Then sew it back to the pants using the segment sewing tool. Active all the patterns and simulate. I recommend that you save at this time. We will move on to the animation editor next. Click on the button on the lower right corner to reset to default layout. Go to the library, double-click on Avatar, then choose Mail, V2, Motion, and select the animation. Make sure Transition Animation is turned on. Click OK. Both the avatar and the garment will move to the start position. Click on the arrow on the bottom to show the animation editor. When we play it at the default setting, we can see the animation is running at real-time speed. It is too fast, and we want more frames for the animation to run to get a smoother result. Scene Time Warp will adjust speed of animation frames. In this case, we will increase the Scene Time Warp to 7. We can apply Strengthen to patterns during simulation. Strengthening the color will make it stay at the neck. The cape has given me some collision issues in the past, so I will increase the thickness to 5, which will make it easier to collide with. Double-click on the fabric for the cape and go to the fabric physical property. I have increased the density to 55. Press the simulation button, then press record. A new track is created, and the simulation is recording. Stop after recording the transition animation. Use the Select Move tool to adjust the garment to the desired starting pose. In this case, I only want to bring the end of the cape back, so I will freeze the rest of the patterns and only work on the cape. You can use Pin tool to help with shaping. The short key for Pin tool is W. Hold W and click will create a pin. Hold W and click on the existing pin will release it. Create a pin on both sides and move it outward, then simulate. Press Ctrl W will release all the pins in the scene. I'm done with shaping the garment for the start pose. I recommend that you save this file to a new version so you can always go back to this point if you need to. Next, I'll add wind to the scene. To bring out the wind controller in Marvelous Designer, click on Display, Environment, Show Wind Controller. Click on the wind controller and you can rotate the wind direction and move the wind source position. The wind strength, frequency, turbulence, rotation, and translation are all keyable. However, before I create any keyframes, I will record a little bit first. The reason why I did this is to save our new adjustments. If I click on the yellow dot to hide this track and move the time slider, the garment snaps back to the last frame of the transition animation, and the new starting shape we created is removed. Have a bit of recording first, we'll save the adjustments. Move the time slider to the desired frame. Make sure the key active is turned on and enter a value. Right click on the timeline and select add wind key. Start the simulation, then press record. In addition to the tag tool, which will constrain the garment to another garment or the avatar, you can also constrain a piece of garment in space. Select Paint Box or Paint Lasso tool and drag a box around the points you want to paint. You can do this either on the 2D window or the 3D window. After the recording is done and you are satisfied with the result, change the scene time warp back to 1. Move the yellow bar on the timeline will assign the range you want to play and export. To export the animation, click File, Export. You can choose the desired format. Here, I'm choosing Olympic OGAWA. Make sure Unified UV Coordinates checkbox is checked if you want to export it with UVs, and check any texture maps you want to export. Choosing Scene will export the garment single-sided. This is a great option if you want to make any post-simulation adjustments in other 3D softwares. Or choose Thick if you want to export your garments extruded by the thickness of the fabrics. Thank you for watching. If you liked this video, hit the like button below and subscribe for more. If you have any questions about getting started in Marvelous Designer or this lesson, please leave a comment below and we will do our best to answer your question. If you want more information on Marvelous Designer, check out our website, forum, and official Discord channel in the link below.